Okay. Last, left unit cases. Okay, now factor words. The factors were defined as a G by Johansen. Factors defined as a G by Johansen. Allele word was coined by Batson. And you know that homozygous and heterozygous. Homozygous and heterozygous word also coined by Batson. Benson coined the term homozygous and heterozygous. Now, next term is hemizygous. To write for this, if any cycles for that you write, if individual contains, if individual contains only one gene of a pair, contains only one gene of a pair, then the individual is said to be homozygous, hemizygous. Then the individual is said to be hemizygous. Genotype and phenotype words are coined by Johansen. Genotype and phenotype words are coined by Johansen. Now, phenotypy. Phenotypy. If different genotypes are kept in, if different genotypes are kept in different environmental conditions, if different genotypes are kept in different environmental conditions, then they produce same phenotype. Then this genotypes are said to be phenocopy of each other. Fighting meaning? How about fighting? Fit for the shanty, the jolo. Different gene containing organisms, when you kept them in the different atmosphere, they show the same characteristic. બદલાય પણ આપણે તો એવા જીન્સ જે છે એ બે ફિનોટાઇપિક સેમ રિપ્રેઝન્ટેડ કરે. વિચારો, વાંચો, બે વખત ત્રણ વખત વાંચો, બહુ જ ઈઝી છે, કઈ અઘરું નથી. When different genotypes are kept in different environment, then they produce same phenotype. You consider here for one gene only, don't consider for all organisms. Different environmental conditions છે. એમાં ટુ ડિફરન્ટ જીનોટાઇપ કન્સિસ્ટિંગ ઓર્ગેનિઝમ ને તમે રાખો છો, સો ઇટ શો સેમ ફિનોટાઇપ, એનું કેરેક્ટર સેમ એક્સપ્રેસ કરે છે. જીનોટાઇપ ઇઝ ડિફરન્ટ બટ ફિનોટાઇપ ઇઝ સેમ ઇન ડિફરન્ટ એન્વાયરમેન્ટ, બીકોઝ ધેટ ઓર્ગેનિઝમ ઇઝ એડેપ્ટ ટુ ધી પર્ટિક્યુલર એન્વાયરમેન્ટ. So that we say that it is phenocopy of each other. For example, flower color. Tame two different types na flower, different areas ma tame joya hashe. Plant is totally different, atmosphere is totally different, but flower color is same. ફ્લાવર કલર ની વાત કરું તો શેપ ને બધું ને, બીકોઝ વેન યુ ચેન્જ ધી જીનોટાઇપ, વેન યુ ચેન્જ ધી જેનોટાઇપ, સો ફ્લાવર શેપ, પેટલ્સ નંબર્સ, ધેટ ઓલ વિલ બી અલ્ટર. આઈ એમ ટોકિંગ અબાઉટ ઓનલી વન પર્ટિક્યુલર કેરેક્ટર. સો વેન ટુ ડિફરન્ટ જીનોટાઇપ્સ એટલે એમાં ટુ ડિફરન્ટ જીનોટાઇપ્સમાં શું છે કે આપણે ટુ ડિફરન્ટ પ્લાન્ટ સિલેક્ટ કરીએ. જીનોટાઇપ ડિફરન્ટ છે એટલે ડિફરન્ટ એટમોસ્ફિયરમાં સેમ ફિનોટાઇપ એક્સપ્રેસ કરે છે. સો ધેટ ફોર પર્ટિક્યુલર કેરેક્ટર વી સે ધેટ ફેનોકોપી ઓફ ઈચ અધર. લિમિટેશન ત્યાં પૂરી થઈ ગઈ. પછી ક્રોમોસોમમાં થિયરી ઓફ ઇનહેરિટન્સમાં ઇમ્પ્રૂવ થઈ ગયું કે નો વન ઇઝ ડોમિનન્ટ નો વન ઇઝ રિસેસિવ. પણ હું તમને એમ કહું છું કે કઈ રીતે એક્સપ્લેન કરે તે તો ન ખ્યાલ આવે. સ્પેસીમેન ઇઝ ટોટલી ડિફરન્ટ બટ ફેનોટાઇપ ઇઝ સેમ. પ્લાન્ટનું આ બેસ્ટ એક્ઝામ્પલ છે. તો તમે ટુ ડિફરન્ટ પ્લાન્ટ્સ તમે ડિફરન્ટ એરિયાઝમાં ગ્રો કરો એટલે યુ કન્સિડર ઓનલી વન જીનોટાઇપ. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ ફ્લાવર કલર તમે કન્સિડર કરો કે ફ્લાવર પોઝિશન કન્સિડર કરો. આપણે ટી પ્લાન્ટ ફોર ધેટ વી હેવ સિલેક્ટેડ ધી કેરેક્ટર્સ નો. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ યુ કન્સિડર ધેટ ફ્લાવર કલર. સો ટુ ડિફરન્ટ પ્લાન્ટ્સ. Plants are different. So genotype is different. I am talking about the flower color only. પછી તમે એને ટુ ડિફરન્ટ એન્વાયરમેન્ટમાં ગ્રો કરો છો. So flower color is same in both. So for particular flower color only they are phenocopy of each other but not for others. તમે કોઈ ફ્લાવર કલર ને કન્સિડર કરો ટુ ડિફરન્ટ પ્લાન્ટ્સ વર્સિસ સેમ ફ્લાવર કલર. સો ધે આર ફોનોકોપી ઓફ ફિનોકોપી ઓફ ઈચ અધર. હા અધર કેરેક્ટર્સ આર ડિફરન્ટ. ફ્લાવર પોઝિશન, નંબર ઓફ પેટલ્સ, ફાઇન ટાઈપ ઓફ ધ લીફ, ઓલ આર ડિફરન્ટ ધેર. ઓલ આર ડિફરન્ટ ધેર બટ ઓનલી કન્સિડર ધી વન જીન. You consider only one factor or one contrasting trait.
Same.
ખાલી એના માટેની જ વાત છે. તો આપણે શું કહીએ છીએ when different genotypes consist different plants. Both are kept in the different environment. And then both the different genotype consisting plant adapt to the different environment at that place and but produce the same color of the flower. So flower color related to that both are phenocopy of each other. Rose માં તમે red color hibiscus જેવો આવે તો એને તમે કહી શકો. પણ એ ટુ ડિફરન્ટ એટમોસ્ફિયરમાં ગ્રો થવું જોઈએ. સિમિલર એરિયાસ માટે સિમિલર એટમોસ્ફિયર માટે કન્ડિશન અહીંયા એ છે કે ડિફરન્ટ જીનોટાઇપ ગ્રો ઇન ધી ડિફરન્ટ એન્વાયરમેન્ટ. So same phenotype, known as phenocopy. Suppose તમે અહીંયા આપણે skin color consider કરીએ. So suppose in the warm area the color of skin and in the cold area also the skin color. Majority when you change the environment, fine. So skin color is same. So we say that both are phenocopy of each other. For particular trait only, for particular character only, not consider all. But you know, genotype is different, so many characters are there. Is it clear?
Yes.
Sure? Okay. Now, Karl Korenz performed the experiment on the maize plant. was again re-experimented by other three scientists. You put a Greece, Karl Korets and Juan Sherman. Right? I am talking about the chromosomal theory of inheritance. So Karl Korets performed the experiment on the maize plant. And Yuko Tabriz experiment on the evening primrose. The scientific name of the evening primrose is Poenothera lamarckiana. Poenothera lamarckiana. The evening primrose plant che, and Yuko Tabriz coined the mutation word first time. He stated that in evening primrose, gradually generation to generation, changing in their characters shows evolution. So Hugo Tabriz stated that for evolution, mutation is responsible. And he performed the experiment on this plant, evening primrose. Scientific name is Poenothera lamarckiana. And Sherman performed the experiment on the many flowering plants. Fine. And then later on, Sutton and Boveri experiment, fine, on that same plants and proved that mental rulers, the factors or alleles or allele of mobs are nothing but these are the genes. Fine. First law of Mendel is law of dominance. And second law is known as law of segregation. Correction of questions related at Dhyan Rajju. Okay, fine. Now, Mendel experiments remains hidden for how many years?
1990.
Mendel's experiment was hidden for how many years? 1856 to 1863, and 7 years to experiment. Mendel represents his experimental documents in Natural Flow History in 1965, and up to 1990 it can be unrecognized due to few reasons. So 34 years is the answer. Fine, so you're not down there. Pea plant is annual plant. Pea plant is annual plant with short life cycle of 2 to 3 months. Pea plant is annual plant with short life cycle 2 to 3 months. Now you know that table, right? 7 characters and 7 pairs of contrasting traits. So please note down in the table, see, actually here the 7 characters and 7 pairs of contrasting traits are located on the 4 chromosomes. 1, 4, 5 and 7 number of the chromosome. In pea plant, on 1, 4, 5 and 7th chromosome, the 7 contrasting traits are located. Seven characters of pea plant are located on 4 chromosomes. Number 1, 4, 5, and 7. Now I will tell you the different characters and the location on which number of the chromosome. So length of the plant, flower position, yes, length of the plant or stem height, flower position and shape of the pod. Located on the 4th number of the chromosome. Pod color, 5th number of the chromosome. Seed shape on 7th number of the chromosome. Whereas seed color and flower color on 1st Mendel optic. Mendel optic. Wrinkle seed due to Mendel obtained wrinkle seed due to absence of SBE स्टार्च ब्रांचिंग एंजाइम, सी द फंक्शन ऑफ द स्टार्च ब्रांचिंग एंजाइम इज दैट इट कन्वर्ट्स द ग्लूकोज इनटू स्टार्च, बट हियर फ्री शुगर मॉलिक्यूल्स आर मोर इंस्टेड ऑफ द स्टार्च, दैट्स व्हाई द सीड इज रिंकल्ड. In wrinkled seed of pea, instead of starch, free sugar molecules are present due to absence of starch branching enzymes. You know that starch is amylose. And you know that word amylose?
Yes.
Amylose is unbranched polysaccharide. And amylopectin is branched polysaccharide. And that's why amylose for digestion of that amylase enzyme is used there. And in amylose, one example is there known as starch. So starch is digested by the amylase enzyme. The word is related to that. So here in wrinkled seed, starch branching enzyme is absent there. So glucose is not converted into starch. Glucose is there in the free form. So free sugar is more present here instead of starch. That is known as wrinkled seed. Fine. So that is the function of SBE, starch branching enzyme. You can apply this for law of independent assortment. So here Forkline method means capital A, it is attached with capital D as well as small b, right? So in this way it produces the gamete capital A capital B and capital A small b. Similar to this, small a connected to the capital B as well as small b can produce the capital A small a capital B gamete and small a small b gamete. So in this way, four different types of gametes are formed. Okay, just for example, if you want to take instead of A, B here, that is also true. Capital B here, so you can write capital A, small a here. So here capital A, capital B, and small a capital B will be there. Understand what I mean to say?
Yes.
And here when you write instead of small a, small b here, and here small capital A, small a here. So capital A small b and small a small b will be there. But at the end of this, four gametes consist same genotype. Four gametes consist same genotypes. Either you take capital B and small b here, and small capital A small a here. Can you understand what I mean to say here? Wait. If you want to perform this method, that is okay. Otherwise, other student ask that, sir, can I do like that? Capital B, I can take it as a one character. So capital N, small a, 50-50 possibilities there, right? So here what happened? Capital A, capital B, and small a, capital B, two gametes are generated there. And if you take small b, then you connect it with capital A, small a. So here capital A, small b there, and here small a, small b there. So here number of gametes in that genotype is similar to that. Yes, but alteration in this two. Fine. But number of gametes are four, that is true. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, fine. Now you make some points here for this. Type of gamete or phenotype category can be identified with the help of 2-10. Wait. Type of gamete or phenotypic category is equal to 2-10. Okay, wait. Here type of gamete. Capital T, small t. So two gametes are there. Capital T in that also two gametes are there. N is nothing but here N is equal to number of characters. If you select only one character here, two gametes are generated. If you select two characters, four gametes are generated. And four different phenotypic ratio there. Right? Here gametes are four, and phenotype is also four. But here you calculate that 2-2. N is equal to, you have to take the 2. Because if you are talking about the dihybrid experiment. Understand? If you will take capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y, in that also four gametes are there. But phenotypic ratio is 1. Phenotypic ratio is only 1 there. Because all the gametes consist same characteristic. Understand? No, that all the types of the equation we have discussed in the NCERT lectures. Fine. So type of gamete or phenotypic category. Fine. 2-2n. Types of genotype can be calculated by 3-2n. Type of genotype is equal to 3-2n. Number of zygote produced by selfing of genotype is equal to 4-2n. Is equal to 4-2n. And now here for this you can write n is equal to n is equal to number of hybrid character, number of hybrid character or heterozygous pair, number of hybrid character or heterozygous pair. Clear? Okay, fine. Here I can stop now.